Now is the time in northern Minnesota when the wild cherries and berries are blooming. So I wanted to give you a introduction to those, and we'll also follow up with part two that we'll talk about them when they're in their fruiting stage. So this video follows up my original Roses by Another Name, talking about the very earliest blooming shrubs in northern Minnesota. This is the time of year in June where the wild summer berries and cherries are primarily in bloom, and how to tell the difference, what to look for. Most wild cherries and berries are also in the rose family, like the Roses of Another Name. There's lots of things in that family. Cherries have pits, berries have seeds. That's it when it comes to identifying which one's which with the fruits. Aronia melanocarpa is a native fruit, also referred to as chokeberry, because it's a berry, it has seeds, not a pit. Prunus virginiana is one of our native cherries, also referred to as choke cherry. Some books refer to it as pin cherry, but for here I'm going to call it choke cherry. And cherries, as you have already heard, have pits. So while we're in the blooming stage, there are a few features that you want to pay attention that will help you distinguish the choke cherries from the choke berries. The choke cherries have a dense cluster of flowers along a main stem. They have oval to slightly egg-shaped leaves, and the leaf stem, or the petiole, has small glands at the base. I'll show you more detail on that in a second. The choke berries, on the other hand, have an erect cluster of flowers. They have a thick, very oval leaf, not at all egg-shaped, and the leaf stem has no glands at the base. And again, I'll show you more details here. So you can see here on the choke cherry, Prunus virginiana, the flowers are along a single long main stem, and then they're tightly clustered around that main stem. And they may be hanging up, down, or sideways, but that all the flowers clustered around one main stem is the indicating feature. Once you start looking at the leaves of all these different plants, you're going to start to notice these differences that you might not have noticed before. Choke cherry, Prunus virginiana, has a very distinctive leaf shape in that it's slightly egg-shaped. It's wider above the middle and a little bit narrower near the base. Every leaf isn't exactly that way, but you look at 10 or 15 leaves, you're going to see those very distinctive leaf shape for the choke cherry. If you've ever read books about identifying choke cherries, they're going to talk about these glands, and it's like, what the heck is that? So I'm going to show you, if you look at the base of those leaves, there's a couple little whitish dots. I'm going to zoom in on it here for you. So I just zoomed in on that picture, and you can see those two little sticky outy things on the red stem just below the base of the leaf. Those are glands. If you have you can see them easily with the naked eye. If you have a hand lens, it's nicer to be able to see them. But they're definitely there if you look for them. So a quick review of the choke cherry, Prunus virginiana. Flowers are densely clustered along a single main stem. The leaves are oval to slightly egg-shaped, and the leaf stems or petioles have small glands just below the base of the leaf. Okay, now we're going to do a walkthrough with chokeberry, Aronia melanocarpa. Much more erect clustered of flowers that are kind of spread out. The leaf is thick and very oval with very distinctive teeth around the edges of the leaf, and the leaf stem has no glands. Let's go look in more detail. So here you can see the cluster of flowers for chokeberry. There's multiple stems, and then each stem kind of divides, and each of those stems then divides more, and each of them has a flower, and then each of those flowers will turn into a fruit. So it's really much more of an upward facing cluster of fruit compared to the chokeberry or chokecherry. Ah. So in comparison to the choke cherry leaves, the choke berry leaves are very uniformly oval, and it's a thicker, kind of more textured leaf than the lighter weight, more flimsy choke berry leaf. And then here, the leaf base and the petiole of the chokeberry, it doesn't have that red color, and there's not even anything remotely looking like a little sticky outy glanny thing. So those are indications that, you know, you're not looking at a prunus species. So just to review again, the chokeberry flowers on erect clusters. They have thick oval leaves with fine teeth along the edges, and the leaf stem has no glands. Well, I hope you enjoyed the wild ones, cherries versus berries, part one. We'll be back with a part two when they're both in fruit, and we can really explore what is this cherry versus berry thing. Well, I hope you liked this video. If you'd like to look at others, check out our website, clovervalleyfarms.com.